Hello guys, my name is Denis Dushan. I'm working in data artist, software engineer. Main language is Java. Sometimes I use Kotlin or Scala language. And my specialization is mainly in finance field, sometimes in e-commerce, electronic commerce. Today I would like to talk about new product from Oracle. Its name is Graal, and especially to talk about one component of this system, of this ecosystem. The name of this component is Graal. It's a just-in-time compiler. First of all, where you can get this product, Graal VM, you have to go to the official site, where you may find a lot of links, especially in doc section and in download section. It's possible to get two different tools. It's two different editions. It's a community edition and it's an enterprise edition. The main difference is that for enterprise edition, if you are going to use it in production systems, you have to obtain license, contact Oracle and get license. But nevertheless, it's possible to use enterprise edition for evaluation purposes. It's possible to download as community edition and as enterprise edition. They are both available for download. Graal VM, it's a big ecosystem. It contains a lot of tools that allow to develop programs in different languages. First of all, Graal VM is based on Hotspot. That's why it's possible to write applications and run applications written in Scala, Kotlin, and Java languages because it contains interpreter for bytecode. Also, there is a special component inside Graal VM. The name is Truffle Framework, and there is some written interpreters for other languages, such as JavaScript, Ruby, R, Python, and even it's possible to run C code written in C and C++. As I said, Graal VM is an open ecosystem, and it's possible to use GVM in OpenGDK. At the moment, OpenGDK contains one component from Graal VM. It's just-in-time compiler. It's available starting from 9 version of OpenGDK. At the moment, it's still experimental. Option, you have to explicitly specify that you want to use this. But in last 2 weeks, Oracle Labs released 19th edition of Graal VM. And as they say, it's a stable release and it's possible to use on productions. Also, when you use Graal VM, there is inside a node application that use Graal VM as an embedded component. It's possible to run not only JavaScript application, but also to mix JavaScript and Java code inside one application. Also, this GVM is part of Oracle database. It's available in different cloud instances. And Graal VM contains a special tool that allows to translate bytecode into standalone executable native images. To summarize this, the main components of Graal VM is, first of all, it's a JIT compiler. The name of it is Graal. There is also a special framework, Truffle. The main purpose of this framework is to write interpreters for your own languages. And using special tools, it's possible to translate these languages and these interpreters into executable programs that may be that is possible to run on Hotspot VM. And there is a special component that uses Graal compiler. The name of this component is Substrate VM. This component is used for generation of native images, images that is close to the machine code and operating system that you use. And the main idea is to write ahead, is to do ahead of time compilation, just translate bytecode into native images. History. This project There were a project, MaxinVM. This project is still active, and it was started in 2005 year. And the main question at the time was, is it possible to write virtual machines in Java? And in 2012, Graal compiler, just-in-time compiler written in Java, was spun off as an OpenJDK project. And now it's part of OpenJDK. And it provides not only just-in-time compiler, but a lot of additional tools ahead of time compilation and to write interpreters for your own languages. If you want to use all these capabilities, you have to download Graal VM distribution, one of two editions, open source community edition or commercial one. Today, I would like to talk about just-in-time compiler. The name of it is Graal. And first of all, I would like to make a little review what is just-in-time compiler and why we need this. As you know, Java source code is translated by compiler into bytecode and then is interpreted by virtual machine. Interpretation is very slow, and in order to run it faster, there is a special component, just-in-time compiler, that translates your bytecode, abstract bytecode, into the machine codes that is close to into the assembly code that is close to the processor and allows to run it much faster. And to depict the main difference of these two VMs, you may see on this slide that Hotspot VM is written in C++ language. All components are written in C++. There is a special interface. The name of this interface is GVM compiler interface that allows to write your custom compiler, just-in-time compiler. Standard edition Hotspot VM in OpenJDK contains two different compilers. One is C1, the name of it is client. You may know this compiler as client. It compiles methods during execution as soon as possible and as soon as application starts. And after gathering a lot of additional profiling information during the execution of your program, there is a special request to the server compiler. You may know this compiler as C2 or Opto compiler. This compiler provides and to do a lot of more additional optimizations and allow to get more faster code for your application, for your methods. Graal VM has replaced this server compiler. This one component is written in Java language. All other components are still in C. There is a purpose to replace also in the future, in some near future, also replace this C1 compiler by Graal. But there is still some research that is still going on this subject. So the main question is why Java? Why to write this just-in-time compiler in Java? Main point is safety. Java language is mature language. It has very precise and formal specification for it. Also, it provides exceptions. It's possible to write code that may be formally verified. And when you write a Java code, it's possible to use different tools, debuggers, profilers, and also it has excellent IDE support. With all these tools, it's possible to write code that has no memory leaks and provides, especially when using debugging, provides to verify, to check if there are some corner cases during development of this of the compiler, just-in-time compiler. The main question is how and why it's possible to write a just-in-time compiler in Java. The main task of compiler is to transform bytecode into machine code. During compilation, GVM asks to compile some kind of methods and passes around only bytes, array of bytes to the just-in-time compiler. And after application of additional optimizations, a lot of optimizations, Graal compiler produces machine code that is installed into the code cache. When this compiled method is available, GVM may use this method during the execution of the program. At the bottom of slide, I copy-pasted the interface of this compiler. There is only one method, compile method, and it receives one object, compilation request. It's a little bit more complex than only an array of bytecodes because there is inside additional metadata is available during execution. GVM may provide a lot of additional profiling information for the compilation pipeline. And now I'd like to talk about compilation pipeline and what components is. It consists of four big paths. First is a Java bytecode parser. It reads an array of bytes of bytecode and translates it into a special graph. This graph has a special form. The name is its static single assignment form. And a lot of compilers, not only just-in-time compilers, use one of two representations. It's a continuation passing style or single static assignment forms. If you search through the web, you may find that a lot of optimizations are interchangeable, and it's possible to convert from one form to the another form. Front-end component then uses this graph and passes this graph through the three different tiers. The main idea at this stage is to translate Java bytecode, these representations, to the graph, to the that is more close to the machine codes. And after going through these tiers, high, mid, and low tiers, we get a graph that is close to machine codes and a special component backend then translates this into the machine code. On the backend stage, it's possible to apply additional optimizations. The name of these optimizations are register allocations and pip call optimizations. Main idea of register allocation is to distribute all variables that are in program and map them to the available registers in the CPU. And another one kind of optimizations is pipcall. It's a little optimizations on the assembly code, usually in assembly code. But as at this stage, graph is very close to the assembly code, then it's possible to apply these optimizations. And after applying, a special component just generates machine code and installs it into the code cache. For example, on this slide, you may see that there is some such notion as phase. Each compilation tier, nevertheless, its front end or back end consists of different phases. This I depicted the main phases of front end, and you may find the list of these faces just using the special keywords during the when you run your application. At the bottom of slide, you may see that there are three keys that you have to specify. It's the first one, use GVM CI compiler. If you use OpenGDK edition, you have to specify this because in OpenGDK, Graal compiler is still an experimental. And in order to run just-in-time compiler, you have to specify eager GVM CVI because just-in-time compiler not run during the application startup, but in some later phases. That's why we need this second option. And to show what phases are inside, you have to use the second option, Graal show configuration with the special value verbose. Frontend consists of several phases that acts on high-level representation of bytecode, on the representation that is very close to the Java code. Here depicted that loop optimizations are applied. After that, the canonicalizer phase is applied. After that, that code elimination phase. And after these three phases, we have inlining phase. And the final one is escape analysis phase. It's escape analysis still exists in older versions of GVM. GraalVM adds a new kind of escape analysis. The name is partial escape analysis. It provides more rigorous information about what objects exist, about their scope, and how to minimize the allocations during the program execution. Now let's talk about these optimizations. What are they, and what these optimizations are? First, I would like to talk about loop optimizations. Why we need them, and what are they? First is loop unrolling. It's very basic optimizations. The main idea is to minimize the number of iterations in the loop. And this optimization is very simple, just copy-paste the body of the loop and decrease the number of iterations. Why to do this optimization? It's because internally on CPU, when control flow changes, CPU has to reload pipeline and jump to another instruction. And these operations is costly, and in order to decrease the number of such jumps, loop optimization just copy the code and decreases the number of it. Yes, the disadvantage of this optimization is so that the code gets bigger. Another optimization is loop peeling. The idea of this optimization is to move out one, usually its first iteration, out of the loop. Sometimes some algorithms contains verifications only on first methods, only on first instructions or first element of some array or data structure, and it's possible to move this verification out of loop. This gives us possibility to verify condition only once before the loop execution. And sometimes this condition may be shortened into simple operation. For example, in this case, the if condition is moved out the loop, and it was shortened only to 32 value. This optimization is a special case of loop splitting, when loops may be splitted into two parts. For example, first iteration or only last iteration. Another optimization is a loop on switch. The main idea here is also like in loop peeling, is to decrease the number of conditionals that have to be verified. For example, on the left side, you may see that there is a verification that variable A is greater than 2. On the right side, after application of loop and switch, verification, this conditional and verification of a variable state is moved out of the loop. Yes, in this case, also there is code duplication. But there is only one verification of conditional. And in this case, it's possible to generate code that has less jumps in the assembly code. Second big group of optimizations is inlining. The main idea of this optimization is just copy-paste the body of the method inside the call side. For example, there is one method, test sums, that invokes two, some increment, with values. After inlining, it's possible to get only one method with two variables and only constants. After application of optimization, the name of which is constant folding, it's possible to, in this case, it's possible to get rid of these additional operations such as plus in this case. Also, inlining is a polymorphic way. It knows about structure of your code and what implementations has your interface or abstract class. As you know, during execution of code, when GVM sees invocation of method on the object, it tries to do virtual dispatch. And in this case, dispatch is a complex operation during which GVM tries to verify the object, do additional null checks, and find the appropriate structure that contains the method that has to be invoked. All dispatches may be split into three cases. One case, it's when interface or abstract class has only one implementation. This case is called monomorphic dispatch. During execution of a method, GVM usually collects a lot of additional information, not only about execution of method, counters how much times it was executed, but also information about a structure of classes and its interfaces. And in first cases, GVM and Graal compiler can inline only one in, can inline method because there is only one implementation. When there are two implementations, then this dispatch is called bimorphic dispatch. In this case, Graal compiler may replace virtual dispatch by simple checks for the type of the object and inline appropriate method at the call site. The more complex case is when interface or abstract class has more than two implementations. This case is called this dispatch is called a megamorphic dispatch, and Graal compiler in this case uses profiling information in order to find the distribution of how often one or another implementation has been invoked in, and in that case just build a switch method and to reorder these instance checks before finding the appropriate method that has to be invoked and inlined. And the final part of front-end is its escape analysis. It's a very big topic, and the main idea of escape analysis is to find the scopes where objects live. Is it live only inside the method, or it may be used outside the method in other thread, or it may be used further down the pipeline in other methods. When Graal compiler finds this information after escape analysis, it may do different optimizations such as scalar replacement, just replace the invocation of a, for example, creation of a new object. It may replace creation of a new object on a heap by placing this creation on a stack, these internal fields. More information is possible to find by the following link. It contains a lot of pages. It's around 30 pages that describes all different cases that is possible. On this slide, I would like to I want to provide example when scalar replacement is possible. For example, in our case, we have a rectangle class that contains only two fields, height and width, and method that calculates area of different rectangles. In this case, rectangle object is not visible outside the method, and Graal compiler may replace the creation of a new object by two variables that will be placed on stacked and assigned these values And during the execution of method will be used, these variables will be used for summation. Partial escape analysis may do more complex verifications. For example, in code, it's possible to have conditional branches, and escape analysis may provide information and move the creation of the object inside the appropriate branch. The main conclusions of this optimization is that just-in-time compiler do a lot of optimizations for us for free. And the main idea is don't do premature optimizations, because in most common cases, JIT compiler will provide more efficient code than we may write. And the main and the core idea is just write idiomatic object-oriented code. If you need more power, just try to use a faster algorithm or another data structure. And on this slide, I just collected links where you may find more additional information about Graal. First link is a main official site. The second one is GitHub repository that contains implementation of this just-in-time compiler. Also inside the GitHub repository, there is a special section, publications, that contains a lot of links that is divided into different topics. One section is for Graal compiler, the second section is for Truffle framework and how to write interpreters for your languages. And the third one is about Substrate VM that allows to create native images. And maybe one of the best tutorials that is available on the internet is it's a Graal tutorial that was given on Programming and Languages Design Conference in Barcelona. It's a little bit long, around 3 hours, but it contains more insights about internal structures that is used in Graal compiler and why